By default, your installation of Creo 4.0 will be set up with the school's configuration. Now that's different than the STARBASE configuration that you want to have in order to have the Creo user interface match the instructions in the STARBASE exercises. So in these next steps here, we're going to configure Creo 4.0 so that it has the STARBASE configuration and matches all the instructions that go along with the curriculum. Before we reconfigure, we need to close out of Creo because it requires a restart in order for the configuration changes to take effect. So I'm going to close out here. Before we change the configuration of Creo 4.0, we have to set the permissions for the folders to allow our configuration program to make changes. So we need to go to the location where Creo 4.0 is installed. If I'm opening up my file explorer, that's going to be in the C drive, under Program Files, PTC, and it's going to be at the Creo 4.0 folder is the one that I want to set the permissions on. So I'm going to right-click on the Creo 4.0 folder. I'm going to select Properties from the pop-up menu. I'm going to open the Security tab, and then the group that I need to change the permissions on is the Users group. So if I click on it here, you can see that the users are not allowed to have full control, and they're not allowed to modify, so that's what I need to change. So I'm going to click Edit. A new window is going to open up. Again, I need to select Users. And you can see now I have the option to click it to enable full control and modify. I actually only need to click in the full control box. It'll set modify if I do that. But that's what I want to have. I want to have full control, and I want to have the ability to modify for my users group. If that's the case, you can click OK. And you'll see the computer run through a bunch of changes here. That's normal, and that's what you want to see happen. With that set, you can click OK to exit. You can close out the folders here. The configuration files that we're going to use are found in the curriculum folder. So I'm going to open up STARBASE_Creo4. Now you'll see at the bottom of this folder contents, I have two sets of configuration files. Now I'm only going to use one of them. I know which one to use based on the build code of my Creo 4 installation. So you can see here, the difference between these two sets of configuration files is the 4-character code at the end, M030 versus M080. If I go to my Creo installation, which is in the C drive, under Program Files, under PTC, and then in the Creo 4 folder, I'll see a folder that has my build code as its name. So in my case, it's M080. However, in your case, it may be M030. If you downloaded Creo 4.0 prior to August of 2019, this past August, you likely have M030. And if you've downloaded Creo 4.0 after August of 2019, you likely have M080. But double check this folder's name in order to know for sure. I'm going to return to that folder, STARBASE_Creo4, and I'm going to right click on my set of configuration files. The pop-up menu will appear, and I'm going to select Extract All. Now there's a very specific location that I need to extract the contents of this folder to. So I'm going to click on Browse. These files need to go in the PTC Creo installation folders. So that's going to be again in the C drive, under Program Files, PTC, and then Creo 4.0. For me, it's going to be M080. For some of you, maybe M030. So we're going to go into that folder. I'm going to open Common Files, and then Creo Standards. This is the target folder. So with Creo Standards selected, I can click Select Folder. And the pathway should look just like this, starting with the C drive, ending with Creo Standards. If that's the case, go ahead and extract. When you navigate to the Creo Standards folder, you should now see a folder named StarBase underscore config. When you open that up, you'll have the configuration materials that you need. And what we do to set the configuration is we just double click the program named configure for StarBase. Now you should see a command prompt open. You hopefully get a message that gives you a list of files that are being copied. It's just saying one file, five files, one file. This is the message that you want to see. If you see a message that says access denied, it likely means that their permissions were not set correctly, so the program wasn't able to copy the files over. And you may also see a message where it says zero files copied, and it says it over and over again, like you see here. In that case, what likely happened is that you're running the configuration program from the wrong location. So double check that your StarBase underscore config folder is actually in the Creo underscore standards folder. But if you get the message like this, then that's telling you that it worked. So you can press any key to continue. And then we can open Creo, we can run Creo and verify that the changes have taken effect. So the first change we're looking for is that we have the Creo StarBase imagery on the landing page. And you can see I have that here. And in my case, I have the new models appearing in the little slideshow. And then another way to verify is by setting the working directory to the StarBase curriculum. And you can choose any vehicle. I'll use the crawler in this case. So I now have set the working directory to the crawler, and I'm going to open the base assembly, the 01 crawler assembly. And with the assembly open, I can verify that I have a StarBase tab. That's part of the configuration. I have the photo tab that includes the photorealistic image, map key, the background map key, and some of the other familiar tools. So now my installation of Creo 4.0, I've verified it's been configured correctly for StarBase, and I'm ready to use it along with the StarBase curriculum.